The Ministry of Secondary Education has developed a distance learning platform for students of secondary education in Cameroon. A series of lessons taught by qualified teachers for secondary school students. Under the stewardship of Professor Pauline Nalovalyonga in collaboration with the Ministry of Posts and Telecommunications, CAMTEL, CRTV, and UNESCO, we are introducing distance learning as another teaching and learning method which is different from the traditional classroom setting that you are all used to. In the distance education mode, you are not with the teacher in person, so take your time, relax, listen to the teacher, take down notes and visit the following links for any questions or answers to your questions. Take it in your stride. This is Cameroon's solution to COVID-19 and beyond. Professor Nalovalyonga, Minister of Secondary Education.
Welcome to lesson 15 of your distance education program in chemistry for upper seat science. I am Longning Gingum Innocent, your chemistry teacher. We are still on the topic matter, properties and transformation, and the subtopic redox equilibria. This subtopic redox equilibria will be covered in the following lessons. Terms related to redox, oxidation numbers and naming of inorganic compounds, balancing redox equations, half cells, standard electrode potentials, uses of standard electrode potentials, part 1, uses of standard electrode potentials, part 2, cell diagrams, factors affecting electrode potentials, and corrosion and its prevention. Before beginning today's lesson, let's correct the assignment we had at the end of our last lesson. Question 1. Define the following. A. Standard hydrogen electrode. B. Electrochemical series. C. Standard electrode potential. Answers. Define standard hydrogen electrode. Standard hydrogen electrode. The standard hydrogen electrode is an electrode that consists of hydrogen gas at a pressure of 1 atmosphere and temperature of 25 degrees Celsius bubbled over a platinized platinum electrode. B. Define electrochemical series. Define electrochemical series. The electrochemical series is a list that describes the arrangement of elements in order of their increasing standard electrode potential values. C. Define standard electrode potential. Define standard electrode potential. Standard electrode potential is the electrode potential of a half cell measured against the standard hydrogen electrode under standard conditions. I repeat, standard electrode potential is the electrode potential of a half cell measured against the standard hydrogen electrode under standard conditions. Question 2. Name the two main types of salt bridges used in electrochemistry. Name the two main types of salt bridges used in electrochemistry. The two main types of salt bridges used in electrochemistry are the glass tube bridge and the filter paper bridge. Question 3. When a copper rod is immersed into a solution of silver nitrate and allowed to stay for some time, a great deposit is observed on the copper rod. A. Explain this observation. B. Using ionic half equations, write a balanced ionic equation for the reaction. And C. What type of reaction is it? A. Explain this observation. Atoms of copper rod lose electrons when the copper rod is immersed in the solution of silver ions. The copper rod loses electrons and go into solution as copper ions, while the silver ions in solution gain the electrons to form silver metal, which is deposited as great solid on the rod. Now, the problem was, explain why the rod will become great. The rod becomes great because silver metal is deposited on the rod in the course of the process. B. Using ionic half equations, write a balanced ionic equation for the reaction. Using ionic half equations, write a balanced ionic equation for the reaction. Notice that in our explanation above, copper metal enters solution as copper ions, while the silver ions in solution, they gain electrons and are deposited as silver metal. So there are two half equations. The copper metal losing electrons to become copper ions, and the silver ions gaining the electrons to become deposited as silver metal. The overall equation for the reaction can be obtained by adding the two half equations. When adding the two half equations, the species to the left of one half equation is added to the species to the left of the other half equations. And the species on the right of one half equation are added to the species on the right of the other half cell equation. The overall equation, therefore, is 1 mole of copper solid reacting with 2 moles of silver ions, aqueous, in equilibrium with 1 mole of aqueous copper 2 plus ions and 2 moles of silver metal. C. What type of reaction is it? What type of reaction is the reaction we've just seen? It is a redox reaction. It is a redox reaction because reduction and oxidation take place simultaneously. Today's lesson is titled Uses of Standard Electrode Potentials, Part 1. The outline of this lesson is as follows. Objectives, prerequisite, uses of standard electrode potentials, part 1, evaluation, assignment, and references. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to calculate the electromotive force of voltaic cells from standard electrode potential values. You should be able to predict the relative oxidizing or reducing strength of chemical species from their standard electrode potential values. Prerequisite. To test your previous knowledge that will be useful in this lesson, answer this question. Define the following. A. Oxidizing agent. B. Reducing agent. C. Oxidation in terms of electron transfer. And D. Reduction in terms of electron transfer. A. Define oxidizing agent. What is an oxidizing agent? An oxidizing agent is a chemical species that gains electrons and is reduced during a redox reaction. I repeat, an oxidizing agent is a chemical species that gains electrons and is reduced during a redox reaction. Now, notice the half reaction on your screen. Copper 2 plus ions gains 2 electrons and is reduced to copper metal. So copper 2 plus ions are the reducing agent, are the oxidizing agent that are reduced in the course of the reaction. So copper 2 plus ions are the oxidizing agent. B, define reducing agent. Define reducing agent. A reducing agent is a chemical species that loses electrons and is oxidized during a redox reaction. I repeat, a reducing agent is a chemical species that loses electrons and is oxidized during a redox reaction. Consider the half-cell reaction. Copper or zinc solid loses electrons and is oxidized to zinc 2 plus ion. So zinc metal is the reducing agent. Zinc metal is the reducing agent. C, define oxidation in terms of electron transfer. Define oxidation in terms of electron transfer. In terms of electron transfer, oxidation is the loss of electrons by a chemical species. Now consider the half-cell reactions. Ion 2 plus ion loses an electron to form ion 3 plus. So this is oxidation. There is an increase in oxidation number as a result of a loss of electron. Zinc metal loses electrons to form zinc 2 plus ion. Zinc 2 plus, not minus, zinc 2 plus. So there is an increase in oxidation number, and so this is oxidation. D, define reduction in terms of electron transfer. Define reduction in terms of electron transfer. In terms of electron transfer, reduction is the gain of electrons by a chemical species. Reduction is the gain of electrons by a chemical species. Now consider the half-cell reactions. Ion 3 plus ion gains an electron to form ion 2 plus. So this is reduction. A gain of electron accompanied by a decrease in oxidation number. The copper 2 plus ion gain electrons and they are reduced to copper metal. Gain of electron accompanied by a decrease in oxidation number, it is reduction. Uses of standard electrode potential. Standard electrode potentials have the following uses. Standard electrode potential is used to predict the relative oxidizing or reducing strength of chemical species. It is used to calculate the electromotive force of voltaic cells. It can be used to predict the possibility of redox reactions. Standard electrode potential is used to calculate the free energy change of an equilibrium reaction. And it can be used to calculate the equilibrium constant of redox reactions. Predicting relative oxidizing or reducing strength of chemical species. When predicting the relative oxidizing or reducing strength of chemical species, the species with the more negative or less positive standard electrode potential value of a redox couple is a stronger reducing agent. It has a stronger reducing power. That is, the more negative, the stronger electrode potential value of a redox couple, the stronger its reducing power. I repeat, the more negative the standard electrode potential value of a redox couple, the stronger its reducing power. That is, a species with a more negative standard electrode potential value, we reduce a species with a less negative standard electrode potential value. The more positive the standard electrode potential value of a redox couple, the stronger its oxidizing power. I repeat, the more positive the standard electrode potential value of a redox couple, the stronger its oxidizing power. So a species with a more positive standard electrode potential value will oxidize a species with a less positive standard electrode potential value. Calculating the electromotive force of voltaic cells. The electromotive force of voltaic cells can be calculated using the formula: electromotive force of the cell is equal to the standard electrode potential of the right-hand electrode minus the standard electrode potential of the left-hand electrode. The symbol E theta stands for the standard electrode potential of the right-hand electrode, while the symbol E theta LHE stands for the standard electrode potential of the left-hand electrode. Electromotive force of a voltaic cell is measured in volt, and the instrument used in measuring the electromotive force of a voltaic cell is a valve voltmeter or a potentiometer. Example 1. Consider three half-cell systems, A, B, and C below. A, 1 mole of copper 2 plus ions, reacting with 2 moles of electrons, are in equilibrium with 1 mole of copper metal, and the standard electrode potential of the half cell is plus 0.34 volt. B, 1 mole of calcium 2 plus ions, reacting with 2 moles of electrons, are in equilibrium with 1 mole of solid calcium. The standard electrode potential of this half cell is negative 2.92 volt. C, 1 mole of lithium ions, reacting with 1 mole of electrons, are in equilibrium with 1 mole of lithium solid, that is lithium metal. And the standard electrode potential of this half cell is negative 3.04 volt. A, which species is the strongest oxidizing agent? Explain. B, which species is the strongest reducing agent? Explain. Answers. A, which species is the strongest oxidizing agent? Explain. Copper 2 plus is the strongest oxidizing agent. This is because the copper half cell has the most positive standard electrode potential value. I repeat, this is because the copper half cell has the most positive standard electrode potential value. Copper is the lowest in the electrochemical series among the three, and so will not reduce lithium and calcium. B, which species is the strongest reducing agent? Explain. Which species is the strongest reducing agent? Explain. Lithium metal is the strongest reducing agent. This is because the lithium half cell has the most negative standard electrode potential value. So lithium is the highest on the electrochemical series. Example 2. Consider the redox systems below, where permanganate, 1 mole of permanganate ions, reacting with 8 moles of hydrogen ions and 5 moles of electrons, are in equilibrium with 1 mole of manganese 2 plus ions and 4 moles of water. The standard electrode potential of the half cell is plus 1.51 volt. And the second half cell system, 1 mole of ion 3 plus ions, reacting with 1 mole of electrons, are in equilibrium with 1 mole of ion 2 plus ions. The standard electrode potential is plus 0.77 volt. Given that the two redox systems are connected to form a voltaic cell, A defines standard electrode potential. B, which would be the positive electrode of the cell? Explain. C, calculate the electromotive force of the voltaic cell formed. Answers. A, define standard electrode potential. Define standard electrode potential. Standard electrode potential is the electrode potential of a half cell measured against the standard hydrogen electrode under standard conditions. I repeat, standard electrode potential is the electrode potential of a half cell measured against the standard hydrogen electrode under standard conditions. B, which would be the positive electrode of the cell? Explain. Which would be the positive electrode of the cell? Explain. The permanganate electrode will contain the positive electrode. This is because reduction occurs in this half cell. C, calculate the electromotive force of the voltaic cell formed by connecting the two half cell systems. To calculate the electromotive force of the voltaic cell formed by connecting the two half cell systems, we use the formula electromotive force is equal to the standard electrode potential of the right hand electrode minus the standard electrode potential of the left hand electrode. Now, the ion electrode with the more negative standard electrode potential value is the left hand electrode. So the standard electrode potential of the left hand electrode is plus 0.77 volt. Now, comparing the standard electrode potential of the two half cell systems, discover that the standard electrode potential of this electrode is the more negative than the other. So this is the left hand electrode with the more negative standard electrode potential value. The permanganate electrode with the more positive standard electrode potential value is the right hand electrode. So the standard electrode potential of the right hand electrode is plus 1.51 volt. Now, substituting the values of the standard electrode potential of the right hand electrode and that of the left hand electrode in this equation, we have the electromotive force of the voltaic cell is equal to 1.51 volt minus 0.77 volt. Simplifying, we have the electromotive force of the voltaic cell is equal to plus 0.74 volt. The electromotive force of the voltaic cell is plus 0.74 volt. It is important to remember that the relative oxidizing and reducing strength of chemical species can be predicted using standard electrode potential values. The total electromotive force of a voltaic cell can be calculated using standard electrode potential values. Evaluation. To know how well you have followed this lesson, answer this question. Consider the three redox systems below. A, 1 mole of lead 2 plus ion reacting with 2 moles of electrons are in equilibrium with 1 mole of solid lead metal. The standard electrode potential of the half cell is negative 0.13 volt. B, 1 mole of zinc 2 plus ions reacting with 2 moles of electrons and in equilibrium with 1 mole of zinc metal. The standard electrode potential of the half cell is negative 0.76 volt. And C, 1 mole of lead 4 oxide solid reacting with 4 moles of hydrogen ions and 2 moles of electrons are in equilibrium with 1 mole of lead 2 plus ions and 2 moles of water. The standard electrode potential of the half cell is plus 1.47 volt. A. Which species is the strongest oxidizing agent? Explain. B. Which species is the strongest reducing agent? Explain. C. Calculate the electromotive force of the voltaic cell formed by connecting A and C. And D. Which will be the negative electrode of the voltaic cell in C above? Explain. Answers. A. Which species is the strongest oxidizing agent? Explain. Lead 2 oxide is the strongest oxidizing agent. This is because the electrode has the most positive standard electrode potential value. B. Which is the strongest reducing agent? Explain. Which is the strongest reducing agent? Explain. Zinc metal is the strongest reducing agent. This is because the zinc electrode has the most negative standard electrode potential value. C. Calculate the electromotive force of the voltaic cell formed between A and C. To calculate the electromotive force of the voltaic cell formed by connecting the two half cells, we can use the formula electromotive force of the voltaic cell is equal to the standard electrode potential of the right-hand electrode minus the standard electrode potential of the left-hand electrode. Now, looking at the standard electrode potential of the two half cell systems, we notice that the lead electrode has the more negative standard electrode potential value, while the lead 4 oxide electrode has the more positive standard electrode potential value. The lead electrode with the more negative standard electrode potential value is the left hand electrode. The standard electrode potential of the left hand electrode is negative 0.13 volt. The lead 4 oxide electrode with the more positive standard electrode potential value is the right hand electrode. So the standard electrode potential of the right hand electrode is plus 1.47 volt. Now substituting the value of the standard electrode potential of the right hand electrode and the left hand electrode in the equation, we have electromotive force of the voltaic cell is equal to plus 1.47 volt minus negative 0.13 volt. Simplifying, we have electromotive force of the cell is equal to plus 1.60 volt. D. Which will be the negative electrode of the voltaic cell in theory above? Explain. Lead is the negative electrode. Lead metal is a negative electrode. This is because lead is oxidized. That is, some of the lead metal or the lead atoms will ionize, leaving electrons on the lead rod and enter solution as lead 2 plus ions. The lead rod becomes negatively charged, and that is the negative electrode of the voltaic cell. Assignment. Before our next lesson, answer this question. Question 1. Define the following in terms of electron transfer. A. Oxidation. B. Reduction. Question 2. Consider the electrode systems in the table below and answer the questions which follow. You have the zinc electrode, the iron electrode, the copper electrode, and the iodine electrode. Their standard electrode potential values given. A. Which species is the weakest reducing agent? And which species is the weakest oxidizing agent? B. Arrange the oxidizing agent in order of increasing strength. C. A voltaic cell was made up using redox systems B and D. Calculate the electromotive force of the cell. References: Chemistry for IB Diploma by Steve Owens, Advanced Chemistry by Michael Cloxton and Rosalie Fleming, Chemistry in Context by Graham Hill and John Holman, Complete Advanced Level Chemistry by Gule Emmanuel Eno and The Internet. We've come to the end of this lesson. Our next lesson will be on Uses of Standard Electrode Potentials, Part 2. See you in the next lesson. Unatege si matege yob, unatege minga matege nyum, unatege majang matege ndom, manetambia ninya ne njubya yen, ngani bana matege mot, ngani la kiri watege ndong, esekina bia dinkido, manetambia ninya ne njubya yen, tamtama mote tamzabike, Tam tam atonge tam zabike tam 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 amote tam zabike mane tambia ninyane njubya yen.